Hi, this is Tim. Today I'm working on a three-phase trainer idea. This is something that a lot of you have asked for, is a way to safely train inexperienced people on three-phase power. Because all of our trainers really are based around 24 volt DC, which is much safer than your typical three-phase power. When it comes to training on the motor portion of electricity, there's not really a good solution out there. So I've come up with this trainer that takes 240 volt three phase and turns it into 24 volt three phase. The math will actually be divide by 10. So whatever it was at 240, you would divide by 10, including amps and everything. It also, you should be able to put 208 into it and you'll just get 20.8 volts. I don't have 208 here, so I'll have to take it somewhere to test that. I take the 240 volt, turn it into 24, and one, we can still use our regular trainer fan. We found out that it will run on 24 volt AC and we ran it for several hours and it seems to be fine. So then if I flip this trainer around, it's still a work in progress because I didn't have a reversing contactor. I didn't have the interlocks and everything. So I need to get the jumpers and the reversing bar, and I had no small overload. So I'm getting a small overload. I still don't know that I can actually trip an overload with this fan, but we're gonna try it. And if anything, it has a test button. This side here will be 24 volt AC, and just for short term, I have wired in switch one to pull in the contactor. I don't know if you can see it, but if we look real closely in here, when I switch switch one, you're going to see this contactor pull in, and you'll see these fan blades start to move. So that is running off of three phase, and our voltages, if we check them, L1 to L2, we got about 26 volt. L2 to L3, we got about 24 volt. And L1 to L3, we're a little low. We got about 19 volt. And I could put some capacitors in there and I'll probably balance that out. But what do you think? Is this a viable trainer? Could we use it to teach three-phase safely? In theory, that you can touch everything on here. Now, I did leave all the control circuit as DC, because I think that is typical of what you're going to see out there. You're going to have 24 volt control for your AC power. So I didn't make 24 volt AC control, but I have some extra space here. And really, I'm semi-tempted. There's actually space for a PLC, even though this is a three-phase trainer. I don't know. What am I missing that should go right here? I guess that's my big question. Should it be like a, I don't know, a micro 820 or 850 PLC, a control logics PLC, or is there some three-phase element that I'm missing? Also, I forgot to tell one other thing. You may even hear a small roar in the background now. I originally built this to operate on 240 volt three-phase, but then I got thinking, what if we could make it plug into a wall? So I made a rotary phase converter that could sit under your desk. And so this actually is generating the third leg. This is actually plugged into 110 volt wall power. We're running it through this to make the third leg. And then we're taking that 110 volt with this third leg generated through our three transformers. And that's how we're doing it. So this three phase trainer, we'll plug into 110 volt wall power. So let me know what you think in the comments, whether this would be a good trainer, what you think should be added to it, and we'll see if we can make it into a real product. Till next time.
Hi, this is Tim.
And this is Amber of TW Controls. We run the automation store. Hey, thanks for finding our channel.
Here's a playlist with some similar videos.
And YouTube thinks you'll like this video.
Please like our video and subscribe to our channel.
And if our videos have helped you make some money and you're not using our products, please consider supporting us on Patreon.
Till next time.
See ya.